Welcome to Raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll talk about how to create asset in Jira. If you wanted to learn more about Jira and their products, feel free to refer my complete Jira playlist. I've already created playlist on Jira functionality, REST API, automations, as well as their third-party add-ons. So I will include all those URL in description tab, so that it will be easy for you to refer. Now, to start with the assets, straight away navigate into the assets, and from here we can create schema. Whenever we are creating a schema, it will connect, track, and manage assets that matters your team, applications, services, infrastructure, hardware, people, and much more. Whenever you want to build any of these assets, feel free to create from schema itself. When you click on this, it will navigate into this page. Select IT Asset Management, use the templates, and from here you have to add schema name, key, and descriptions. Post that, click on create schema, and this will help you to navigate into the next page, where it will take few seconds to create the schema itself. I already created the schema itself, so I'm just opening this and show you how we can work in it. Once you will create the schema, this will looks like that. From here you can see schema tree. First is hardware. Within the hardware, if we want to add any laptop for any employee, you can add it from here. Just click on plus icon. It will ask you to enter the product name. So at this time I am just using desktop. Icon, you can select any icon whichever you feel or comfortable with it. Maybe I will just select, there's nothing like desktop. I will better we can stay away with workstation itself. This is a hardware assets. That's the reason I will select hardware asset and click on create. This assets will be created successfully, and here you can see this product is available. Under this you can add the person name, or even in the initial stage you can add or specify the person name here itself. Once the object is generated or schema is created, you can add the relevant products. Here I want to add iPhone. This is a parent, so it will be added under the parent itself. Now you can see this is product added. So here let's consider I want to modify this. Let's consider if we wanted to onboard any employee and IT team is creating, or project manager is adding the request to the IT team to get ready with all those assets which is required to onboard that employee. That point of time it is needed. Now here let's say I wanted to create iPhone, and here create object iPhone, name of the person which is allocated. So I'm just adding Deepak Rai. Asset tag, if you have serial number, model name. If you want to specify the model name, purchase order number, invoice number, lease contract, everything will be included here. Once you are done, you can create this and you'll see this informations will be added successfully. From here, we can also edit object, export object, printing QR codes, and deleting the objects. Similar way, from here also, if you will select on the title, it will give you options to modify it. If we want to hide empty or attributes, we can also do it. Or if we want, we can create the clone of it, which we can rename it to something else. So here I will add second employee name, and is Raigurukul. Click on clone, and this will be added successfully under this bucket. This is how we can add the asset types, schema tree, and other details. Let's consider I wanted to add for server related informations. So here, let's consider the new employees who is joining, they will need a NAT server. So I will specify the NAT. Here we'll add server. Parent is a desktop, and then descriptions. Click on create. This will be added successfully. As I mentioned, even we can onboard any employee, and once this employee data is available, here we can add other details like required application, software, servers, assets, everything will be included here. Within the object itself, we can also list down all those required assets or required details from itself. So here if I wanted to include some other software or data which is needed to onboard any employee, which we can include it. This is how we can create any assets team tree within a Jira instance, which will be helpful for a new employee to be onboarded or new employee's data to be onboarded. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.